There we go. I've whispered it to you. You can copy paste it. We're going to be watching Genesis versus Mocha EU International Finals, lower round one. This is from day one of the RLCS on, I believe, August 6th. Let me check. Yeah, this was 6th of August. And the loser of this match is going home. They actually scheduled it so that there would be two teams going home after day one, which is harsh, but that's how it is. Like every team played two games in day one. This series is insane. Johnny, you suck. Thanks, dude. I appreciate it. What's stiffness for? Camera stiffness?
And now,
Just set it somewhere in the middle. Trust me.
Game.
0.5, you'll be fine.
I know it's been a long day, but I'm
what up, Vortex? How you doing, man?
Because this is going to be a good one. So let's go ahead and toss it over to our casters, Leafex and Lawler. Take it away, boys.
I don't think Golden Boy could say it enough. This is absolutely huge. Whoever loses this one is gone. They are out of this tournament.
They thought the pressure was bad earlier. Just wait.
You see right behind the casters right here. Look really quickly. Look behind. How did they manage to make Espeon and Pluto look so insane? Like, complete nerd slayers right here.
This one is gone.
Camera guy is just MVP. The GamePro TGP, I appreciate that. How you doing?
Everything.
How old is Quinn? 23. This video's only got 420 viewers. Needs more views. Everybody should go follow this channel. It's Rocket League Esports. Everybody should go follow them and subscribe. Subscribe, brother, because you can't follow on YouTube. Just subscribe. Cux looked amazing. Yeah, Cux's picture was probably the best one. Probably the best one.
Simply to boost that confidence, get some of that momentum going, and that's going to be the big role, is who gets that first win, I think, is going to really have an advantage coming out through these two teams.
Big Daddy Lobdell. Quinn was the oldest player who played on stage. Bipod was a year older, but he was Flipside substitute, and I was a year older, but I was the Marquee's Guardian.
Might help out, but you just never know.
Again, I mentioned it earlier, but a lot of misplays, mistouches coming out of Genesis, as long as they fix that up.
Who said top 5 EU teams were better than the best NA team? I don't think anybody said top 5. Top 4, maybe. But SA are a top 4 EU team. They didn't go to the LAN. Kainos are a solid team. Maestro had the best picture? No, I think Kux's picture was better than Maestro's. You think Mike's was good? Mike's was good, for sure. But I think Kux's was good as well. Probably the best one. What did Mocket do to their logo, by the way? Look at this travesty of a logo. Their old logo is so much better. Like, has anybody got it? Has anybody still got the old logo? I don't know if anybody still got it. But either way, like, their old logo is so good, and now they've got this. Looks like some school kid made it. He's like, I like fire! And bright colors. Yay! And the Genesis logo. I think Seismic made it. It's so cool. I love it.
Who's gonna take it? This is it. This is
why did I become Mark's guardian? Because he's incapable of looking after himself.
Team loses this. Best of five is going home.
Who did I have winning it all before LAN? Flipside. Opinions in the new game mode, haven't played it, but it looks pretty good.
Yeah, we look at, like, I'm looking at the stats, and statistically speaking, Mocket does have a better overall team, but when it comes to that one player on Genesis, Espeon shows up, especially in the clutch.
Especially. Lawler, killing me now.
Like we know him to. That's exactly why James Bond thinks he's so sick.
Especially sick. We'll see, though, already.
Bit of a rush hit there by Espeon. Nobody was challenging him, and he still went for the hard clear. And ended up dumping it in the middle of the field for the pressure to get put back on them.
Good clear, he does get it past Turbo, but easy push back in from Pashy. As we still see Genesis, a little bit trouble on their defense right now, breaking up. But finally, Quinn does get one on target, almost in. Sicky.
I think that was Turtle, cross X, bones, GGs. That was Turtle who had the arms crossed, like, chin up, eyes down picture. That's like the opposite of the quintessential gamer pose. Gamer pose is usually like, you know, chin down, eyes up, where they're just like, like that. That's like pretty much every gamer profile picture of all time. Chin down, eyes up. But Turtle was like chin up, eyes down kind of thing.
And now the counterattack, they have two back, three versus two, they have a chance.
Instead of a play, they just took a shot, but it's easy clear, but now
Bash. Whoa, Pluto really thought Quinn was behind him there. But it turned out to be fine, so even though the ball centered right across the net, nobody was there for either team.
That connected, it would have been a good play, but Pashy was
did I watch Rocket Royale today? Yep.
Regardless if it connected.
Supersonic Avengers and Kings looking very, very good.
On target, but Turbo to the side. Pluto a little off on that read there, but he does manage
Lawler
to
tossing himself. I know, right?
Getting some of the touches that they were missing earlier, and this is going to be a much closer game.
Yeah, battling back.
Pluto trying to half flip, but he doesn't know how to. He'll need to watch my tutorial when I make it later. Half flipping, like, man, it just feels so good when you know how to do it. That's something that I just love doing, to smoothly navigate around the field. That wasn't a bad pass from Pashi, but Turbo, I guess, wasn't ready for it. He ended up hitting the shot backwards. Bang. Bang. Yeah, double bang from Espeon. Boy bang, and again, boy bang. Accidental bumps coming in from Pluto. Excuse me. Who had the coolest car? I'll think about it. But right there, see, right as I was answering that question, notice this is a problem, a recurring problem of... See right there. That's a recurring problem of Genesis. Quinn doesn't like to let the ball go past him at his own goal. If the ball, he knows, Quinn knows that this shot is on target, right? And he doesn't like letting it pass him, even though Pluto's got a far better clear than Quinn does. So Quinn, in this situation, should just say yours or something, or Pluto should say I've got it, and Quinn should just leave the ball. He should just let it go past him. But what happens is Quinn goes for an awkward save, pops it, and let's say that Pluto had already committed to a save there and forward, like, flipped in the direction of the ball, he would have gone straight under it and Turbo would have had an easy shot. But luckily that didn't happen because Pluto held his flip and he can actually go up and contest Turbo and actually fakes him really well. Fakes a high clear, Turbo just goes straight over. But that's actually a problem that Genesis have, and Quinn will need to... He'll need to stop doing that if Genesis are going to succeed as a defensive force. Because something that separates good defense from great defense is a great defense know when they can let the ball go on target because somebody behind them has a better clear than they do. Oh, Espeon with the dunks. Espeon is spectacularly good at dodging off the wall in his advantage. Something that I've noticed for Espeon is he kind of just levels himself at the same horizontal plane as the ball is, and then he just dodges towards it. Like, he'll either point his nose at the ball in front flip, or he'll be side on and side flip, or, you know, you can figure out how to get from A to B. But the whole point is he levels himself with the ball horizontally and then dodges towards it. That's the key. Notice whenever Espeon's dodging off a wall in the direction of the ball, he just gets the right height on the wall and then makes his journey. Because some people are like, how is he so good at dodging off a wall? I watched closely, and that seems to be, to me, the biggest thing, or the most noteworthy aspect.
Off the backboard, Turbo getting a nice touch back at the midfield. Espeon trying to intercept to put a shot on target. That could be a chance there for Pluto, but he goes for a boost instead. Espeon just trying to...
Those weren't accidental bumps. You can hear the cars from miles around with those ears. Lamau. For a second there, I thought that you were going to argue that you deliberately bumped earlier, and I was like, ready to argue against you, and you got me. I fell for that. It's good play by Quinn right there. Oh, that's not good play by Quinn, though.
Pressure coming up from Mock and Pashy, almost pushing that one past the defender. Turbo getting in the way out to Sicky.
Very cagey game. Both of these teams, sort of similar defensive style, where they like to use the wall to make saves. Pluto and Espeon in particular love the wall, and so does Sicky and Turbo. And then Pashy and Quinn aren't too different in playstyle either. They like to, you know, make things awkward, get up close and personal, take 50-50s. Oh, the autocam kind of blinded us there, but Pluto, not a good idea by Pluto here to make this hit. Okay, there we go. That's how it went straight in. I was wondering how it made it past the goalkeeper, but what a save by Turbo. Or what a save, what a redirect by Turbo. He definitely needed to make that touch, or else it was going to go straight past, or straight into Quinn. Besides turning around faster, how is the half flip helpful? What do you mean? Like, it turns you around quicker. What do you mean besides turning around quicker? What else do you need? What else do you need? Besides getting from A to B quicker, why is using boost better than not using boost? Learn how to half flip.
one that brings out the aggression.
Good night, sweet princess. Yeah, I know. You retain your height with a flip. That's why leveling yourself horizontally with where you want to be is all you need to do when you're flipping off a well. Because the only thing you can do is move horizontally with a flip. Tips on getting painted wheels? Play Rocket League or maybe slide into the DMs of Psyonix Cordy. Keeping the oohs and ahs. I love the ambiance. I love it. Of course you're going to keep the ambiance signs on. Do pro teams ever ask me what they could do better? Yeah, all the time. I get like pro players DMing me all the time about their individual play, their team play. I help people here and there. Because for me, I just want to benefit the scene as much as I can. I obviously don't want to spill all the beans on everything I know about Rocket League, because then that would kind of devalue my coaching, because I would just be freebieing everything. But if I think that something's fairly common knowledge, or at least it should be, then I'm open to tell people how to do it. Like half flips, for example. Who would be my first choice for mic replacement? Me, obviously. Yeah, there's a Kronovi way, the diagonal half flip, and then the regular back flip. And there's no better or worse. They're both situational. If you want to go straight back, like if you literally want to turn around from facing one way to facing the opposite direction, then the straight back half flip is the best option. But if you want to go from here to that way or this way, then the Kronovi half flip is better. Like, they're both situational. I prefer the straight back half flip because I play keyboard and it's very, very easy to do on keyboard. Like, super easy. But I can do it on controller as well. A lot of people have trouble doing it, but the fact that I already know how to do it on keyboard, I just do the exact same thing on controller, and it's no problem. Yeah, Yumi Cheese Man has brought up a good point, but that's not only relevant to half flipping. That's just dodging in general. Is in a recent, well, maybe not a recent, ooh, what a prediction by Siki. But in a sort of recent patch, Psyonix introduced this mechanic in the game that if you get bumped into the air, or if you fall off a surface, such as the, let's say that you drive into the goal and fall off the crossbar, you still have your dodge for an infinite amount of time. It used to be that if somebody bumped you, you couldn't dodge. You had to literally fly back down onto the ground before you could use your dodge again. But now, if somebody bumps you, your dodge is still there for you to use. So if you dodge straight away, then the bump gets cancelled. Like, somebody tries to bump you away, you dodge, and you break out of it. So it's sort of like a reaction thing that you want to add to your repertoire. Do you think I'll ever play regular analysis for randoms? Probably not for free, because I don't really see the incentive in it for myself. It doesn't sound very exciting, or doesn't seem like something that people would want to watch. But sub wars is something that I'll probably do in the future, like my subs against somebody else's subs. Like, let's say my subs against Findable Carpet subs, my subs against Lawler subs, my subs against Jamesbot subs, we can cast it. I could see that happening. I've not talked about it with any of them, but it's an idea that I've got in my head. What's the best kickoff tactics for playing it safe in threes? Lose the kickoff to the corner that your teammate is going for boost in. And bear in mind, when I say teammate going for boost, I don't mean the goalkeeper. You have three people in 3v3, obviously. One person goes for the kickoff, one person stays in goal, then you have one person who's sent sort of free to do what he wants. I would recommend that that person goes to get boost in the back corner, and you lose the kickoff intentionally to that side. That's the most reliable kickoff strategy. But you need to have a wide repertoire of kickoff strategies or you become predictable. Did IBP get painted wheels? I don't know. Maybe. For me, I've already got two painted wheels, so I'm not that bothered. I'm not investigating a topic very carefully. Oh, that was a wide open net. So close. Oh my. The post completely outplays Genesis right here. You can kind of forgive them for this, but both players going back in the same line is a misplay. Autocam not really telling the full story here, but we saw Quinn and Espeon taking the same line back. They both expected it to come straight off the well. It would have been much wiser for one of them to take a different line so that they don't get outplayed by the inside of the post like that.
another shot on target. Oh, Quid just gets into that.
You'll go in the back of the goal and flip out to get back quickly. Yeah, that's a fun way to recover right at the goal, is instead of like turning in the net and driving out after a 180 degree turn, just drive straight out the top of the goal, like drive in and out again, and then just air roll to land on your wheels. You can even throw a dodge in there to increase your momentum. Oh, so close. Nearly a really nice goal. Any tips on learning new kickoff strategies? Pay me to teach you is probably the fastest way. Apart from that, just watch pro players. Watch replays of yourself. When you lose a kickoff really hard, watch the replay, figure out why. Watch my 1v1 analysis where I talk about kickoffs. Apart from that, the most basic tip I can give you, oh, this goal, hold that thought, this goal is unreal. Sick as a god. Oh, what a goal. Beautiful. What if AutoCam at higher FOV? I don't really like AutoCam that much for spectating. I thought that the AutoCam at the LAN was pretty cool. It was better than what I was used to, or at least maybe that's just placebo. I thought it wasn't too bad. But for me, I prefer player cam. I feel like I can understand what's going on much more clearly through one player's eyes than the AutoCam. What do you think would be the best three-player team? Probably... I don't know, Kuxer, Marky, Kronovi, or something like that. But if I have to pick three players from different teams, I'd say something like Kuxer, Kronovi, and then either Greasy or Maestro. Probably Greasy, just because he's more of an outgoing personality. Bang! The LAN boy! The first game was so close between Genesis and Mocket. The Genesis are probably feeling okay with it, even though they lost. But this game was like Mocket actually scoring some decent goals. So Genesis, you wouldn't blame them for feeling really, really down after this game, because they got outplayed pretty hard. Somebody was asking... Somebody was asking earlier about kickoffs. I think that the most important thing to do in kickoff is just make sure that your car is between your goal and the ball, perfectly between the ball and your goal when you actually hit the kickoff, and flip straight into the middle of it, off the ball. Just hit the middle of the ball as hard as you can. Can't go far wrong with that. You're still going to lose some kickoffs because that's just the nature of 50-50s. Like, some people will say, oh, come on, I did my kickoff like really well and I still lost. Well, that's just mathematics. Let's say that you do your kickoff really well. You do a kickoff that's going to win like 80 or 90% of the time. That's a lot. That's a pretty high percentage play. But it's not 100%. You're still going to lose 20 or 10% of the time. And if you lose it, you're not going to have to think, well, guess I need a new kickoff strategy. Nah, it's just the sample size is too small. You can only tell if your kickoff is bad over a large sample size. Unless it's just plain stupid. Unless your kickoff strategy is just stupid, then sure. Honestly, surprising that I've crew in my ADL 3. Didn't think I thought much of him. Dude, I had him in my top 3 players before the LAN even... I thought him in my top 3 NA players before the LAN even happened. Then they won the LAN. Of course I think highly of crew. As I said, they're just playing a little bit slower. They're watching their opponents well, letting them make mistakes and then just capitalize. Is there any use to dodging in a half flip in between tilting backwards and rolling onto your wheels? Well, you have to. The half flip starts off with a back flip. The half flip starts off with a backflip, and then you basically recover. You backflip and then you recover. Because what does a backflip do? It gives you momentum in the backwards direction, but your car is still facing forward. So the half flip is like you start off with the backflip, so you've got momentum in the backwards direction, and then you just air roll your car to land facing the other way. So that's what a half flip is. Is you backflip to start and then you recover and start. You basically point your car in the direction that you're actually traveling. That's the easiest way to understand a half flip.
Let's go as Mocket, trying to make that early attack. It always feels good if you get that first goal.
That was such a Quinn touch, by the way. Such a Quinn Landboy Lobdell touch. Like, this is basically what Quinn does. He just sits up in awkward positions and does weird things. And Pluto nearly getting a goal. Pashy probably didn't have it if Pluto put it in the corner. Have I fixed my keyboard yet? Yeah, I fixed it, don't worry. It just kind of fixed itself. I don't know what I did, but it's working now. Is Scrubs kickoff a fast kickoff? Not in the strict terminology sense, because a fast kickoff implies that you only dodge once and then hit the ball with while your car is four wheels in the ground. But Scrubs kickoff, he actually dodges once to reach the ball, and then a second time when he gets to the ball. So it's not, he does it, he gets there quick, but not as fast as the fast kickoff does. How to fix rubber banding? Tweet at Darkened. Did I expect Over Zero to play as well as he did? I didn't expect Over Zero to play as well as he did. I thought he would play well, but I didn't think he'd play that well. I'd be surprised if anybody thought Over Zero was going to play as well as he did. And I think Lucchino was an even bigger surprise. Like, Lucchino was so good.
And there it is. The first goal on the scoreboard is in favor of Genesis.
Unconventional the way you're going to beat this defense. You see that ball hitting the backboard, but Pluto, rather than
shooting... Alright, Siki expected Pluto to shoot on target there, so he jumps preemptively, but really good play by Pluto. Just putting the ball away from Siki leaves the open net for Espeon. That's what I've been talking about a lot for this event, is teams were shooting a lot more at the goal than they do online. Online teams pass a lot more, I think, than they did at the LAN. Because the LAN just, the nerves and the, you know, pressure really got to people. I wouldn't change the IBP LAN. They just won the RLCS LAN. Why would I change anything? Doesn't matter how good you are. Even if they had, like, Cucks offering to join them, I would say no. Because they just won the LAN. They're the team to beat right now. Yeah, I might teach you guys how to do Scrubs kickoff later. I'll do a one-take tutorial on it. Talk about the physics behind why it works. Should take like 2 minutes or something.
A really, really good punish there for Pluto. He bumped him out of the way, being that last man back. Fortunately for Mocket, they're not able to put it up, but still, this defense coming up from Pluto, trying to do...
Is quick kickoff good anymore? Yes, just not in 1v1. What the quick kickoff does is you're most likely going to lose the kickoff, which, like I said earlier, is very, very safe, because lots of teams right now are cheating forward in 2v2 and 3v3, and the quick kickoff makes sure that the ball doesn't stay in the middle the vast majority of the time. The vast majority of the time the ball is not staying in the middle, which takes the cheater out of the game. So many close shaves for both teams this game. This is some very good interplay between Espeon and Pluto. Oh man, the autocam is screwing us up every time that it goes in this position. I don't know why it tries to, like, go backwards across the goal. Why doesn't it just reverse into the corner and, like, show us what's happening in front of it? That's the second time that we've missed a goal from that exact position because autocam gets screwed. Best player in the world? Probably Cuxer 97. That's just my opinion, though.
And that's a scary spot to be when you're down two on the series. Turbo with a shot, a little bit too wide. That's not going to go in as Genesis tries with a sword. Pluto feels backflip off the backboard. Pashy tries to get in himself. But Quinn,
that's really lucky for Pluto that Pashy didn't see him backflipping by accident.
Good pressure coming up from Genesis. You see them working up as a unit.
Kickoff cheating, how exactly? A cheat is basically somebody moving into a position that they think the ball will go into before the ball actually goes towards that position. Another great pass by Quinn. How did he even get this? Well played. Quinn completely out of boost, but he manages to dodge forward to the position the ball's going to land in. To say on its core, you have a Twitter? Probably. At Johnny Boy, you're a pleb. Yeah, right back at you, dude.
Put that to the far side. And now, once again, back up in the lead on the scoreboard. Minute 40 left for them.
Cheating on kickoffs is a straight-up misplay? Not necessarily, because what cheating can do, besides actually taking possession of the ball, is let's say that the ball goes back to your goalkeeper on kickoff, and your guy who cheats secures a middle boost. Your goalkeeper can then put the ball forward up towards the guy who cheated, like pass the ball forward for a redirect. Man, Mocket have hit the post and the bar so many times. That actually, that last crossbar hit was worse. Because it was the fact that it was so close to going in was actually worse than had it, you know, hit the flat of the wall and come straight back. Because when it hits the ground, or hits the bar and goes straight down into the ground, then it takes pretty much anybody who's following up on it out the game, because they're not ready for it unless they're geniuses at reading rebounds off the bar.
incredible pressure. And if they keep that pressure up, eventually someone on this Mocket squad is going to fall out of their defensive position and allow a goal opportunity. It's just a matter if this Genesis team can keep up that pressure.
Did somebody just call Dracova a dude? As far as I'm aware, that is not the case. Well played by Pluto, by the way. Oh, and then Pluto is slamming Quinn in the bum. Kappa Pride. Do you think losing kickoff can be good to give your team possession? I literally said that like 5 minutes ago. I'll give you guys a little bit of behind the scenes. So I was definitely wanting Genesis to win the series because Genesis are my favorite team, just personality-wise. They're the team that I'd talk to the most by far from NA going into the LAN. Obviously, all the other teams at LAN were really nice. Also, Exodus, Kings, IBP, great guys. But Genesis, I really wanted them to do well here. Even if they didn't win, I wanted them to just put on a good show because I really like them. And after they went 2-0 down and Mocket just wiped the floor with them in game two, I was like, oh no, another 0-3 for Genesis. They're just going to get sent home without any wins. So I just went to the bar. I just left and went to queue at the bar, got a beer. Then I came back and they'd won a game. I was like, okay, they've won a game. Still didn't want to get my hopes up, and I wasn't really paying attention to game two either. I was just talking to the person beside me, and I didn't want to get too into the game because I was worried that they just lose. And so yeah, at this point, I'm like, please Genesis, just win one more game. Just make it at least a 5-game series. That's all I ask. I just didn't want to see them. Going home. So I believe the next line will be EU-based. I mean, I'm pretty sure there was a forum post that said exactly that, so probably.
Pluto can make those hits. Pluto's very good mechanically. You saw him with that backboard clear that he's so good at, where he comes up the wall and then jumps at it. Even though the ball's nowhere near it, he wants to be the...
Do I think that you should wait for coaching? Well, it depends. It's entirely up to you. I've coached prospect players before, just last week I coached a Challenger 1 player. And he had a really great time. The level of the player that I'm coaching doesn't actually make that much of a difference. I can show people how to improve regardless of what level they're at, because I've just put more time into analyzing Rocket League than anybody else has right now, so that's just my speciality. If somebody's in doubt as to whether I can make an hour of their time worthwhile, then challenge accepted.
Alrighty, game number 4, Genesis.
Ooh, Pluto Savage. Is Pluto going to go for more demos? He was actually, but greeted a little bit for the boost in the corner. Good pass. Not the greatest shot, though. Oh, what a shot by Siki. That's much better than his first shot of the game. Again, Quinn refusing to let the ball go past him because it's on target. Right, Espeon's going to save. Now, Pluto's in net. I'm not sure if Pluto would have been able to get that, but the clear that Quinn did get wasn't very good. Do I coach PS4 players? Yeah, I've coached PS4 players, but what I need PS4 players to be able to do is to make videos of their replays, because I can't watch PS4 replays on PC. So I need them to record their replays and then send me the video. Who do I think will pick up Pashi? I've got no clue.
Off the wall now, seeing if they can get another one. Siki to follow him up. No play out of that.
Me taking credit for Genesis winning. I just didn't want to see them lose, dude. So I stopped watching after game two. How much for coaching? $50 an hour. I'm going to start up a Patreon pretty soon, run everything through that, so I'll have different levels on it. That's going to be my hourly one-on-one coaching with Discord to communicate with each other and do some live one-to-one replay analysis. I do the same rate for teams, so if somebody wants to bring along their teammates or their teammate, then that's fine by me. It's the same time. Obviously, it decreases the amount of time that I can offer one player. The mind game broke good. But, it makes it more team-oriented. Quinn's just like, bah! I actually remember I talked to Quinn about this goal, and he told me that he didn't know what to do because the ball was coming at him, and he's like, do I touch it? Do I leave it? So he just, like, wiggled, and then it went in, and he's like, yes, it worked. You're thinking of switching to controller? It's never too late, bro. Like, if you want to be the absolute best player, controller is certainly more intuitive, and there's one or two things a controller does better than keyboard, such as when you get bumped on keyboard, you automatically start air rolling into the ground, because air roll forward and accelerate is the same button on keyboard, but on controller, those two buttons are different. It's the analog stick and the right trigger, so there's definitely an advantage to controller there. Also, you can dodge... you can steer and accelerate in different increments with a controller, requiring much less actions per minute than a keyboard does. So it's just easier to play. But I mean, I just play for fun, so I just play with keyboard, because keyboard's more fun for me. It's also kind of nice being a niche player, like one of the few keyboard players. Kind of waiting for a pass up the field be good during a fast break. What I would say, if you're waiting for a pass up field, just usually the time that you want to do that is right after you've gone up for a 50-50 or a clear ball. I'll try and spot some opportunities. So right there, Espeon just went forward to try and center the ball. Now he's upfield. He just got demoed, but he was already upfield. He didn't need to overtake a teammate to get there. Well done by Pluto. So right here, Espeon, same thing. If this ball, for whatever reason, ends up behind him like that, if somebody centered it right now, like that's okay for Espeon to stick around there because he didn't waste much time. He didn't overstay. Same again, Espeon tends to be the person who's like going for 50-50s early this game. So these are times when you can stay upfield and look for a pass. Like right here, if somebody passed the ball towards Pluto, that would have been fine. But you don't really want to like lurk upfield for a long time, like doing circles in the other team's half, because your team's probably going to need you to help them defend more than they need you to be up for a redirect. Is changing your air roll to right stick any useful? Rizzo air rolls with right stick? What? I can't imagine that would be very useful at all. Oh, look at the most... Is that like the reverse high five by Quinn and Pluto? Look at this. Which way is Quinn's hand there? I'm pretty sure Quinn just gives him his hand like this, then they're like, high five. Yeah, he did. That's so weird. Why did Quinn just present Pluto with like the... Yeah, the backhand low five. That's a bit odd. A bit of an interesting strategy. Why did Quinn just do that? Present the backhand. He's like, look at my fingers, dude. See my nails? Cut them this morning. They're fresh. Looking good. I feel like he could have just gone like this, and then it would have been more like, yeah. That's us in the lead.
Beautiful play from this team coming up. Pluto with the softest touch.
Yeah, I should coach IVP and Co. How to high five and fist bump. Story about that. Lucino's girlfriend is the worst handshaker slash fist bumper I've ever met, or the best, depending on how you look at it. I met her on the Wednesday, and I was like, "What's up?" And I presented the fist bump, and she papered it. I was like, "You did not just do that." And then, like, the second time there was a couple of, like, fist bumps throughout the event. They all went fine because she was in fist bump mode. Then, what's it called? When we were leaving, I think she was in the lobby when me and the Flipside guys and Kronovi were leaving to catch our plane back home. And she, like, you know, said bye and put her hand out, so I put my hand out as well, but when I did that, she probably remembered, oh no, he's a fist bump guy, so she changed to the fist bump, right? So I put my hand out, I was like, oh, it's happened again! The cringe! But it was funny. It was definitely funny.
going to go wide. Quinn keeping that alive with Siggy off the backboard. No one follow up. That's a scary spot for this ball.
You're right, that's a scary spot. You see, Espeon wasn't ready for that at all. Just like hits off the curve and comes straight down on his head.
Espeon gets a touch, and that's going to drop down. Quinn's trying to get another one.
Quinn keeping it up. See, when Genesis took this, at this point I was like, yes, I believe. Come on! Come on! I really wanted Genesis to win, just for my boys. Quinn, Pluto, Espeon. Such nice guys. Opinions on children. They're definitely necessary for the future of mankind.
They need to make sure that they just settle down. They need to make sure that they're not going to go overzealous and commit and then make mistakes. And that's
what are the ideal controls for controller? Just swap boost and jump is the only thing I would say is definitely necessary. Besides that, you probably want to move either ball cam or air roll slash drift to one of the bumper keys. Like, if you want to, like, just have your thumb for boosting and jumping, then put your ball cam to, like, right bumper and your aerial drift to left bumper. Then you can accelerate and go reverse, air and ball cam, drift, aerial, and then boost and jump is all your thumb needs to worry about. And then you steer with the left thumb. That would be, like, probably perfect. And then you could have look back on the circle or something, so if you want to, like, do the backwards look, you don't need to press the right joystick. For me, if I was, like, coming up with, in theory, the best Rocket League controls, you want to spread the inputs to different fingers and thumbs. Because default is a nightmare. You've got to air roll and drift with circle. You've got to ball cam by holding triangle, boost with square, and jump with your knuckle of your thumb. Absolute nightmare. The SARP guys are insane for doing that for so long. Would I rather have to start every sentence with, I'm not racist, but, or would you rather actually be racist? Probably have to start every sentence with, I'm not racist, but. That could be quite funny. I'm not a racist, but that's a really nice save by Espeon. People would be like, what? You can see Espeon's confidence is, like, really, really improved after he got his goal in Game 3. It's just so important to feel confident on LAN. That, you know, when you go up for the ball, you're just flying straight and true, and you're hitting it as hard as you can. Espeon's just beasting right now after scoring his goal in Game 3. How much do you donate to get a 1v1 game against Kuxer so I can point out your mistakes of a Grand Champion player and a Star player? You'd have to ask Kuxer. I mean, well, that's probably going to take 10 minutes or something. Maybe 12 or 13 if Kuxer scores like 15 goals and watches every replay. So we're talking, you know, going by my original rate of 50 an hour. Oh, there we go. Pluto with a long shot. Before I get back to that, look how spread out Genesis are right now. They're not getting in each other's way. They're not getting, like, too close for comfort. They're just giving each other space. That's good rotation. You just give your teammates space to do what they want to do. No, I'm not going to start every sentence that I'm not a racist, but... You want to move boost to a bumper? Yeah, that's fine as well. Boost to a bumper is fine, like R1. Totally fine. Basically, anything to do with controls, I would put jump on square, if you're talking about a PS4 controller. Jump on square, and then just move some stuff off the thumb pad. But yeah, we're talking like a fifth or a sixth of an hour, so, you know, $10, and me and Cux would have to double it because it's 2-man hours, so I don't know, $20, I bet. Maybe Cux would do that for a tenner each. I'd have to ask him. Donate $20 to have one game against Cux with Johnny analyzing. Man, do you think anyone would actually do that? That's a pretty good deal if you ask me. For everyone involved. The reason that you've got to price these things so high is because that's something I would not want to be doing all day. I would not want to watch Cux and mince some noobs all day and be like, well, another, you know, some people might do that for $2 or $3, another $2 in the bag. Wonderful. Had to watch another 20-0. That's exactly how I want to spend my day.
wall. Can he pull out something sick? Just a little bit too wide. Sicky going to take advantage to put that back.
You would do that? I'll talk to Cooks here, see what he says.
Just over halfway, and Genesis still only up by one.
Yeah, back and forth, and this is where Mocket needs to put some pressure. This ball is now in their favor, but it just doesn't seem to matter. Pluto's going to take this over, but the read, and Espeon's there to save it.
But the read!
Has not been let up by Mocket yet. They're still putting on Pashy with the both steals, as they try to keep this attack alive. Minute 40. This is going to start getting scary for Mocket, especially when they have the lead. Good touch from Sicky out to the middle, but no one to finish it off. Pashy, Turbo, both short of that one. They're just going to try to keep possession. Pashy doesn't get it.
All right, enough talk about controls. I don't want to know what everybody's control schemes are. Espeon with the bump on Quinn. That would have been such a good opportunity for Quinn. Espeon accidentally getting in his way. I could buy a raw mutton. Yeah, I could buy a lamb in Scotland for £2.
Back to midfield. Espeon high in the air. Can he get the follow-up, the dunk on Pashy? Not quite, as he does push it inside, but Quinn, it keeps
a mercy rule like 10 goals is GG. Yeah, if Cooks goes up by 10, it's GG. But now people would be sad because, you know, they're not getting as much for their money as someone else is. So we'd have to just do field games.
I mentioned earlier how Pluto is one of the best goalies. He's tied for second in NA, but tied for fourth in the world for saving.
Yeah, I know. I would definitely stream that. I would definitely stream that. Don't worry.
To keep this Mocket team from scoring.
30 seconds left for Mocket to make a move. Genesis looking for that reverse sweep. This could be it for Mocket. If they don't get something started up, they are going to go in. You're going to see hard commitments to this ball and pressure.
Turbo's so panicked right now.
Quinn almost to finish it. The nail in the coffin almost coming out.
Is it useful to hold boost while dodging? Not for the entire dodge if you're front flipping or back flipping, because halfway through a front flip, your car is actually pointing the opposite direction of where you want to be going, so your boost will be counteracting your flip. And the opposite for back flipping. Yeah, Genesis, reverse sweep. So good to see a reverse sweep. Oh, high five denied for Pluto. Quinn, the LAN boy. Cannot believe it. What's that noise? What's IGN? Oh, that's your in-game name. Add me on Steam, dude. I'll see if I can hook you up with a 1v1. Oh man, I'm gonna have to take notes of people. There we go. Let me just close the notepad of pluses.
That's what Rocket League's about, man. This is a community. We're in this together. We've gotten to this point.
So that's your cows for 1v1s against Cucks. All right. Noted. I'm sure Cucks will be all right with that. I don't know. Maybe. I guess he will. We'll see. If he doesn't, then I'll find someone. That was 20 euros, not even dollars. Wait, was it 20 quid? It was 20 pounds. That's like $25 or something. That's like $26. Wow, you got your... I got my money's worth there. Brain aneurysm, so. Oh, Espeon. The boy wonder.
With Espeon of Genesis.
What a nice guy.
What in the world just happened? A reverse sweep. I can't believe it. How are you feeling right now?
My knees are shaking. It's like...
Palms are sweaty, mom spaghetti.
After the second game, we were down 2-0. Quinn was like, one more. And I'm like, nah. Three more.
So the entire time James was watching, obviously your mother supporting you here. I have now told James that I want to be your father. So this is what we're doing. I've adopted you. It's on Twitter. It's on the internet. Espeon, that was a huge win. Mocket, one of the best teams coming out of Europe. Now you move forward into the bracket. And really, my question for you is, did you just need that first goal to really get you going? Because I feel like after you specifically got your first goal, you just went on a tear.
It's true.
Yeah, I think that's kind of true. I mean, I was kind of not feeling that confident coming in. And yeah, like the first series, Quinn scored, or he stole like my only goal. So what are you going to do? But I think that really did help. We knew Mocket was a defensive team, so goals were going to come hard, but... after we started scoring, it really helped us build up that momentum, and we kept going from there.
Nice, nice. They kept going from there.
They kept going from there.
I know you wanted to hang out with your team, so congratulations. Guys, give it up for Espeon and Genesis. They're moving on to the next round.
Espeon doesn't know where to go.
Toss it over to Espeon's proud mother, James Bott, and the rest of the analysts.
I am so proud of Espeon for staying in there. And Genesis is like,
I would love to watch Genesis games with James Bott. I've said this before, but watching Espeon games with James Bott, emotional roller coaster, I'm sure.
And then they just kicked it into high gear. Espeon, especially Quinn, played solid all day long so far for Genesis, but really Pluto stepped up big as well.
Yeah, but I thought you would lose your voice from all the screaming during games 3, 4, and
that goal from Turbo, though.
Pashy had the shot, but it wasn't.
The autocam didn't do that when Justice.
And games 1 and 2 were all Mocket.
Are they going to show the passing goal? Yeah, this is sick. What a pass. Great finish as well, to be fair.
Oh, that goal from Pashy on that angle was just a killer, but Genesis.
Then kaboom! That was the turning point. As soon as Espeon scored, he just started playing with so much more confidence. Golden Boy nailed it. It was spot on. I mean, Quinn was just there early. It was not easy to score.
This long goal, that's what Pluto does, is just get those long range goals. But he was playing so fast. Pluto is an incredibly fast player, but he wasn't doing that well at the start. He was playing with some nerves, but really started to pick it up and was that anchor in the back, just denying those balls, getting those long shots, and just preventing Mocket from getting any sort of offense going.
They used the terrible autocam to make the mobile one high-performance replay that much better. I'm sure you're right. Is it possible to learn a different controller scheme after thousands of hours? Yes, it is, because the way that the brain works is perfectly capable of, you know, relearning things pretty quickly. Which pro wouldn't be called fast? Who's the slowest pro player? Who's the slowest pro player?
You did it. You guys got that reverse sweep, the first one ever at this live event. And
I don't know, like somebody on Dutchman, maybe Vogan. He's pretty slow.
Yeah, plus both four seeds.
Who else is slow?
They're both alive in day two, both in the lower bracket.
I mean, Siki isn't the quickest player.
The LAN environment is completely different from playing on the
as well.
Well, we're getting close to closing out the day.
Turtle's pretty fast, actually.
But we'll be right back here tomorrow. It's going
to Moses is not the fastest player.
Kings of Urban. And these are two teams we all
I'm talking to RLCS players. Like, being slow isn't necessarily bad. It just means that you're not, like, you know, supersonic as much as other people are.
That should be a delight of a match.
What else? Who else?
So don't go anywhere. You're watching the RLCS International Final. We're live from Hollywood. Be right back.
I mean, Mike used to be quite slow and calculated, but now he's much faster. All of Northern are very fast. Fireburner's not the fastest player. Yeah, just as Isu Sigal said it in the chat as well, Fireburner's pretty slow. All of IBP are pretty fast. Quinn's not the fastest player. Yeah, there we go. That's all my slow pro player. That's my slow pro player list anyway. But it's not necessarily bad. It's just like, the thing to remember with being fast or slow is that if you're going at supersonic, that's the fastest that you can go in the game. So there's like a speed cap, right? And if there's a speed cap, then that's, you know, that is the skill cap for speed, you know? And there is a very obvious speed cap. It's actually like when you got the sparkles plus your boosting, I think you go 5% faster. It's like supersonic is basically the fastest you can go. That's ideally, in a perfect world, how fast anybody would be going for the full match, because then you're covering the most distance, you're using boost efficiently. So in theory, like if somebody who plays a perfect game would be supersonic the whole game, and they would always arrive precisely on time with, you know, perfect routing, never, you know, weaving. They would just take wide angles and arrive at the perfect moment while being supersonic. That's, in theory, the best way to play. So I can understand why people like to play a supersonic, because in their mind, they're thinking... hold on, let me just make a note here. That's like the skill cap for speed. So they want to play at it and get used to that, which is not wrong. Right, here we go. Flip side versus kings. Let's